president thus far.
Say hello to Biloxi and Mayor Holloway and everyone else who's here, and I thank the people at the high school who made the facility available to us today. We're glad to be here. I am honored that my longtime friend Keyshawn Johnson is supporting Hillary for president, and we became friends when I was president and he was playing in the NFL, and he played a very important role in the effort we made to get sports figures involved in our race initiative to get people to reach across racial lines and build a common future together. And I'm very honored that he has decided to support Hillary. He's been great for us all around the country. Ranger Jones is, he was a little bit too modest. When you were the top enlisted aide to the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, you got the best job any enlisted man in the entire United States Army can get. He was deeply respected, and we thank him so much for his service. I think there are three or four reasons that people from Mississippi should support Hillary for president. You just heard one of them. There's no question that she is the best prepared to be commander-in-chief and diplomat-in-chief to manage this country's relations with the rest of the world. And we have to restore America's standing in the world as the major source of leadership for peace as well as security, for fighting the war on terror and for making a world with more friends and fewer terrorists. We have to do both those things. And you know, about half the world's mad at us today. You probably noticed that. And I think it's important to say that she would be the best for military and diplomatic reasons. And let's just deal with the military issues first. She's the only member of the Armed Services Committee on the When the Republicans were still in the majority in the Senate back in 2004, Pentagon put together a small commission to plan the future of the American military. They asked one, only one United States Senator to be on the commission. They asked Keller because they thought she knew more, cared more, and would contribute more than anybody else without regard to party. That's what she wanted. And since she's been a senator, she has worked in a bipartisan way to help our soldiers and to help our veterans, to pass bills to get body armor to our troops quicker, to guarantee that when members of the National Guard serve overseas, if they are injured and they need health care, now when people from Mississippi come home, they get the same health care benefits regular military personnel get for life. That's a very big deal to them. And she did that. She passed a bill that guaranteed that all of our soldiers coming out of Afghanistan and Iraq are tested for traumatic brain injuries, which is a huge problem. We have tens of thousands of your fellow citizens who have lived through wartime injuries that no one has survived in previous wars. Many of them have brain injuries because of the impact of the explosive rattling their brains around their skulls, interrupting the kind of networks in our brains that you take for granted, that will enable you to walk out of here without even thinking about why you're doing it. She met a young lieutenant at one of her trips to Walter Reed Hospital a few months ago who illustrates why you need a president who gets this. This young man said to her he was being fitted for a prosthesis on his right arm. His arm was blown off below the elbow by one of these roadside bombs. And he said, "Now, Senator, don't feel bad about me. I signed on, I was honored to serve, and my body is in much better shape than a lot of people who have been wounded over there. And this prosthesis will work just fine." But he said, "I need some help in getting my brain back." And she said, at first, she didn't know what he was talking about because we had a great conversation. He said, "Oh, I can talk to you about military history all day long. I can't go outside unless my wife writes down everything I have to do and directions to get back home." There are thousands of your fellow Americans like that. And you want a president who will not let happen what happened after the Vietnam War, where we confused an unpopular war with our obligations to our veterans. She will never do that. She will never do that. That's why, even in some of these states where she didn't have enough money to compete and she got beat in these states that didn't have a good profile for her, she won the veterans vote. Because they know she's on their side. And every American should know that. She has a good plan for for bringing down our troops, bringing them home from Iraq, leaving a small contingent of special forces in the north where there's no fighting in case the Al-Qaeda make a comeback, because they are the enemy in the war on terror. And we don't want, and we don't want. You know, let me just tell you something. This is all this is, an inside job deal. It's not an inside job. There were 19 members of Al-Qaeda who did it, and they murdered a lot of Secret Service. Put their lives on the line on that day, and that's where it got taken care of. So it's not funny.